Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, it's going to be all about 3D text and how to add different materials to your text. For instance, if you want to do some kind of a Chrome text or something like that, that is what this video is going to be all about. If you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. And if you want to support the channel even more, why not push the join button and become a member of the channel? Push the button and learn more about memberships on this channel, all about the perks and what you will get if you choose to join. With that out of the way, let's start to add in some materials to our 3D text. Let's get right to it. Okay, so let's get right to doing some basic texture inside of a Fusion. So let's jump into Fusion. Here I have a Fusion composition, and I did do a composition already. Something super basic. It's just a 3D text with some directional lights. If you want to know more about how to do something like this, you can check the video up here from last week about doing 3D text. But for this thing, I want to add in some different texture instead of this normal white texture. So what I want to do is I'm going to add in a note. I'm going to push Control Spacebar, and I'm going to write in replace. And what we actually need to add in is a replace material 3D. So I'm going to select that and add that in here. So if we want to add in a material, actually inside of DaVinci Resolve, there is some pretty free materials and stuff like that you can add in. So you'll find those in the effects library, and you'll go to templates, to Fusion, and then we'll go into shaders. And in here we have different things. For instance, you could take like a chrome, and you can then double click and see how that is all built if you're interested in that as well. But now we have our chrome, and we're just going to connect that to our material. And I don't know if you can see that, but now we actually got this metal look. But because of the lights, of course, it is a little different, but we can change the lights around super fast here, and then we can actually see that we're going to get this metallic look pretty fast. And of course, this is our backlight we are playing around with, so we have a front light, and we can do the same for that. So you can see that we have this chrome metallic look to our front, okay? So, but what if you don't want to use this template inside of Fusion? We can just delete it. And I'll go into my media pool, and here I have just some photos. I'm going to add in a photo. And again, I'm just going to put this into the replace material. And now this has been replaced with this texture I have right here. And of course, we can go into the lights. And I'm just going to close that down. Into the lights here, and we can change around the different light sources as we did before here. We can change this. And now we're having the texture. I'm just going to zoom in here. So now we have this photo texture here. And again, this is just a question of messing around with the lights and making it look like you want. Also, we could easily just disconnect this. You can actually see the difference. Here is the normal one. Here we have a photo texture on, which is some kind of a metal look. Again, if we go into the media pool, we can drag in another effect here. So I think this is a texture of a tiger. This doesn't fit, so we can add in a transform node
to the picture here, and in the transform node we can just scale this up so it will fit. And then we have a, again, we can go in and mess around with the lights because the textures are different and they should be lit that way as well. Something like that, maybe. Here we have a tiger text, and well, that's fun and dandy. I think this is super fun to play around with. I'm just going to add in here some, again, wall textures. And if I want to, I can just put in the transform here yet again, and then I can size that up or down. And again, playing around with the lights, giving it the look it deserves and needs to be this texture thing. Again, super easy way to give your text some kind of texture. And I know there's different ways of adding texture to your titles, but this is by far the easiest way to do so. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.